Hi friends, welcome to today's session. First question for the day. With reference to yellow rust recently seen in the news, consider the following statements. Statement 1. It is a disease that appears as yellow stripes of powder or dust on cotton crops. Statement 2. It can spread rapidly under congenial conditions and affects crop development. Which of the above statements is correct? Option A, 1 only. Option B, 2 only. Option C, both 1 and 2. Option D, neither 1 nor 2. Correct answer here is option B, 2 only. It is a disease that appears on wheat crops, not on cotton crops. As you can see on the picture, yellow rust or stripe rust takes its name from the appearance of yellow colored stripes produced parallel along the venations of each leaf blade. The disease usually occurs early in the growing season when temperature ranges between 2 and 15 degrees, but it may occur to a maximum of 23 degrees. High humidity and rainfall are favorable conditions for increasing the infection. This may affect the crop development and eventually the yield of the crop. And this question is important because yellow rust was recently detected in wheat crops in parts of Punjab and Haryana. Second question, a fruit tree said to be the first of its kind in the country was recently flagged off from which among the following states? Option A, Uttarakhand. Option B, Bihar. Option C, Andhra Pradesh. Option D, Sikkim. The correct answer here is option C, Andhra Pradesh. It was recently flagged off from Tadipatri railway station in Andhra Pradesh. The fruit train was carrying a load of 980 metric tons of locally grown bananas to the Jawaharlal Nehru port in Mumbai, from where the consignment will be exported to Iran. We know that the Jawaharlal Nehru port in Mumbai is nearly 900 km far from Andhra Pradesh, and this helps save both time and fuel, as 150 trucks would have been required to send a consignment of this size. And this question is important because this is the first time in India that an entire train is being sent to the gateway port for export. And the last question for the day. With reference to the Finance Commission of India, consider the following statements. Statement 1. It is constituted by the President under Article 280 of the Constitution. Statement 2. It redresses the vertical imbalances between the taxation powers and expenditure responsibilities of center and states respectively. Which of the above statements is correct? Option A, 1 only. Option B, 2 only. Option C, both 1 and 2. Option D, neither 1 nor 2. The correct answer here is option C, both the statements are correct. The Finance Commission is a very important constitutional body. It is set up under Article 280 of the Indian Constitution. And the Finance Commission is constituted by the President of India. It was established in the year 1951 to define the fiscal relationship framework between the center and the state. As we know that the center has more revenue than the states. So the center has to share this revenue with the states for the state's development. So it is the Finance Commission which decides on this, on what proportion or on what criteria this share should be made. The Finance Commission aims to reduce the fiscal imbalances between the center and the states, that is called vertical imbalance, and also between the states, that is called horizontal imbalance. It promotes inclusiveness. A Finance Commission is set up every 5 years. It is normally constituted 2-3 years before the period its recommendation become valid. For example, the 15th Finance Commission was constituted on November 2017 to make recommendations for a period of 5 years from 1st April 2020 to 31st March 2025. The functions of Finance Commission are setting up rules regarding the distribution of tax revenues between the center and the states, determining the principles governing the allocation of grants in aid to the states and the local bodies, determining the magnitude of grants in aid allocated to the states and the local bodies. This question is important because the report of the 15th Finance Commission along with an action taken report has been tabled in Parliament, and the commission is headed by N.K. Singh had submitted its report to the president in December 2019. That's all for today, guys. We will meet tomorrow with another set of questions. Thank you.